Chapter 28, Shattering Armor 2. In the last chapter, I touched upon one of our most common experiences, being overwhelmed by situations, breaking down, and then having a chance to go beyond limitations. As a death and rebirth process, it takes place on many levels and can be called shattering armor because old forms and personal patterns are destroyed and refashioned to make way for the new. Likewise, the death of a physical body comes when it can no longer fully anchor the light of soul. In a sense, you could say that soul has at last outgrown its shell. While this kind of phoenix rising happens dramatically at the individual level, as we pass through all sorts of cycles, shifts, and life losses, it also governs collective evolution and happens to have a starring role at the present time on Earth. As we all know, many prophets, channels, and indigenous traditions have predicted severe earth changes in the next decade and attribute it, in no small part, to dysfunctional human consciousness. As Gaia is a living system, sensitive to human thought and energy over the ages, I totally agree. Yet most of these speakers also consider it a cleansing time or a time of purification. Sure, it looks like that, and will look even more so if and when wide chaos occurs, but this level of analysis is actually too simplistic. Although it occurs or concurs with common sense, the reward versus punishment model of karma is somewhat childish. Actually, the laws of soul and planetary evolution are far more subtle than that. But to really appreciate the beauty of our collective world armor shattering, we need to know a bit more about personal karmic process. When we turn our attention to the great work of individual soul evolution, the first thing to understand is that there definitely is a piece of work to do, the total development of the body-mind-spirit system. While it is a joint collaboration between higher self and ourselves, we being its light spark in form, the work is guided by our own free will through the choices we make each step of the way. Nevertheless, there are discrete lessons programmed into the scripts of each lifetime, and while higher self cannot learn for us, it has ample tools at its disposal to optimize our potential to achieve specific goals. As we can all attest, the process of shattering armor is one such tool used to help us raise the pace of soul evolution. Beneath the unique lessons slated for all souls in 3D form, there are primary types of energy adjustment which must be made. As the basic agendas of particular lifetimes, these include 1. Rectifying imbalances, which is decreasing excess and supplementing deficiencies. A simple example is adding emotional sensitivity to a soul that's already got great mental power. This could be done by taking birth in a loving, poor peasant family without educational opportunities. 2. Growth in particular areas, i.e., the development of particular soul qualities. Such qualities are usually found in the basic trinity of love, wisdom, will, but also include the radical reversals and redirections that pepper pivotal lifetimes. Examples include the basic transit from material to spiritual concerns, often inspired by significant people and events, or shifting one's emphasis from partnership to self-based learning, which is strongly catalyzed by the death of a mate. 3. Balancing responsibilities. A more advanced form of balancing, this is ultimately a way to refine the direction of will. A common example is the balancing of personal needs with the demands of others. This is one of the main lessons offered by marriage and family life. And 4, karmic returns. Similar to the old reward and punishment model, this allows reintegration of personal energies previously accumulated or split off. Examples include past life violence and current domestic abuse, great karmic merit and extreme good fortune, and chronic emotional avoidance that draws to us relationships full of drama. These are also forms of readjustment. Regarding individual soul evolution, the point is simple. Previously imbalanced choices necessitate specific rebalancing experiences, all of which are known and aided by higher self, and must be met with love and acceptance by the soul in veiled 3D incarnation for successful resolution. Karma is thus offset, and body-mind-spirit readjusted when we heal our wounds, forgive our enemies, embrace our sorrow, and take responsibility for painful events. But this can happen only after full frontal direct confrontation, being wounded, meeting enemies, suffering the shadow, and absorbing the trauma. While you could certainly judge all this as, quote, punishment for past sins, nevertheless, such hardships are actually various forms of greater self-exposure, fully known by higher self as a potential catalyst likely to inspire us to make the needed adjustments in attitudes and mental emotional biases. From the perspective of higher self, there is no bad karma. We can surely consider these difficulties to be times of purification and cleansing, but events in and of themselves cannot make us grow. They are simply the lawful result of our previous choices and our ways of thinking, feeling, and action. Evolution via incarnation proceeds through a continually self-mirroring process of life experience. Neither reward nor punishment, events and what they bring up for us are the basic forms of catalyst designed for self-learning, rebalancing, and spiritual polarization, i.e., the paths of virtue and vice. Shattering armor in and of itself doesn't purify. We purify ourselves. It's not even accurate to say that life teaches us particular lessons, since only we can do the learning. Life and events are just as they are. We are the boss of whether or not we get anything substantive from them. Let us at least give ourselves due credit. When we look then at world process, there are even more complex dynamics to consider. Intertwined with individual soul evolution and karma, there's also, one, the life path of the planetary logos itself, sometimes called Gaia. Two, the lives of the animal, plant, and mineral kingdoms. Three, devic or angelic groups at all levels of evolution. Four, interdimensional ET races related to Earth, so-called inner civilizations. And five, the group life or group soul life of humanity itself, the collective oversoul of humanity. While we can't go into the details of such thickly interwoven group karma, still, all these players have some degree of influence on world events, and are, in turn, influenced themselves by the global process. They are all players in the current dimensional shift on Earth. Therefore, in the same way that higher self programs life experience as catalyst for personal growth, the planetary logos offers Earth changes as an armor-shattering type of catalyst to all groups who partake of Earth life. Just as individuals respond differently to similar challenges, so too will each group make different use of the chaos. But in all cases, the karmic process proceeds according to universal laws of cause and effect. For humanity, geological upheaval offers a needed interruption in our chronic spiritual complacency, and may inspire some to see the error of their ways and choose a more balanced, heart-based lifestyle. As with individual catalysts, some of the larger world changes are planned from above, while others are wholly the product of humanity, either directly or otherwise. Yet even those events are modulated by higher levels and are intimately tied to human consciousness. The more humanity acknowledges and accepts its latent dis-ease, anger, fear, greed, and ignorance, the less severe the Earth changes need to be. As humanity takes off its own armor, there's less need for external assistance. As always, divine counsel remains the same. Soul, know thyself. Simply put, the root purpose of the entire manifest creation is self-knowledge, and the function of all life events, whether programmed by higher self, chosen through wisdom or ignorance, experienced alone or in relation to others, or occurring at social, racial, or planetary levels, is to mirror and inspire our efforts to move forward in evolution. In other words, to help us move from conflict to harmony. The sequence here is easy to trace, but also most elegant. Over lifetimes, our personal and collective distortions, which is a lack of love, exquisitely create the karmic patterns that then generate the conditions, planned by higher self or drawn in by ourselves, in which those very same distortions can at last be healed. Bear in mind, the karmic process of environmental mirroring for greater self-knowing need not be traumatic at all. In fact, on most 3D worlds, it is not. But when souls and soul groups create all sorts of mental-emotional barriers to the inner light, at both individual and social levels, then all such walls must first come crashing down before real self-discovery can begin.